Commonwealth title, it is the Mountain Warrior, Shane Cameron, and the Dominator, Dominic Vea. Cameron with the experience, 28 fights, 26 losses, 26 wins, one of two losses to David Tua. Let's take a look at the maths that really matter here, and 3 years separates the two. Slight height advantage to the Kiwi, a slight reach advantage to the Aussie. Nothing separates on the scales. For the official introduction, let's go centering to Rick.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is for the Commonwealth Cruiserweight title and will be boxed over 12 by 3 minute rounds. Please now make welcome into our red corner this evening, our Kiwi visitor, Shane Cameron.
So if you don't mind, say, I can see you're out of aces.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome into our blue corner, Sydney's very own Dominic Vea. Ladies and gentlemen, now the official introductions from the land of the long white cloud into our red corner. We welcome a fighter wearing the white shorts with black piping. He's trained by Barry Michael and fights out of the Boxing Alley Gym. Hitting the scales tonight at 89.9 kilograms, a bronze medalist at the 2002 Commonwealth Games. He brings to the ring a record that shows 28 fights with 26 wins, including 20 by way of knockout from Auckland, New Zealand. He's the mountain man, Shane Cameron. His blue corner opponent tonight is a Sydney born and bred local. At the weigh-in, he logged in 90 kilograms as his official fight weight for tonight. Trained by Dylan Nye, with 15 fights on his card, winning 13 of those, 10 by way of knockout. He's known as the Dominator. Please welcome Dominic Vea. Your referee in charge of all the centering action for this bout, Mr. Charlie Lucas. Judges ringside, Gary Dean, Anthony Shipley, and Les Fear.
Are you ready for a war on main event boxing? Okay. Because I reckon that's just about the perfect description. Fighters being called in to centre ring.
Okay, boys, I've already spoken to you in the dressing room. You know exactly what I want. Remember, they come to see you fight. They never come to see me referee. 12 rounds, touch them up.
Yes. The stare down as the former champ, Kostyuzu, looks on. Not retired, officially, not yet anyway. The former number one in the industry. Solomon Hamono in the corner of Dominic Vea. John Hoppawattie is here as well. As the two men start work for the night, the end of a 12-week preparation for both boxers and the reward, the Commonwealth Cruiserweight title. Cameron in the white trunks, Dominic Vea in the black trunks. Evenly matched statistically. Most of us will have lasting memories, Daniel, of a show put on by your crew at the Grange, old school boxing. Dominic Vea, Oscar Siale last year at Penrith. We have not seen a bigger war, I don't think, in a decade of Aussie boxing.
Yeah, there was a massive fight. Both guys threw a lot of punches and landed a lot of punches, but to their credit, they stood up for the whole time, and it was a good, great fight.
If we get to the trenches tonight, we know Vea will certainly go there. Two orthodox boxers, very similar in all stats as you read down from age to height, reach and weight. Two big cruiserweights. Two guys that weighed in under that 90.71 or 200-pound limit, but they would walk around, I would reckon, probably at 100 kilos, every bit of it, and they're probably fighting tonight at 96 kilos.
I mean, Cameron has fought a fair bit heavier as well.
Yeah, certainly campaigned for most of his career. And the heavyweight division. Decided to come down after that second round loss to David Tua. A huge fight. A massive setback it was for the Mountain Warrior. We saw him in this very building, Shane Cameron, going back a few years, a devastating eighth round knockout of Aussie Bob Mirovic. Two absolute giants at the time. As Cameron launches there, very much feeling out process. A lot of the time in the heavier divisions, Dan, we see one or both boxers come out and looking to throw everything right then, right there. Sometimes you come out and you see the old school feeling out process, and that's what we're seeing here.
Yeah, that's it. And Cameron can bang as well. I had the pleasure of watching him when he was still in the amateurs. When I was still in the amateurs as well, and he was a big puncher back then, and he's turned into a great puncher these days.
A lot of people expecting a long war here, but if you look at the resumes of both guys, high percentages as far as KOs. So both have got the heavy hands, capable of stopping. Final couple of seconds. Round number one for the Commonwealth Cruiserweight title. Speaking of big boys that can throw them a little bit, well, big Bazza. Barry Hall is here in the crowd. Is there a future as a pugilist for that man once the boots go up for the final time? Any of the boxing guys that have seen big Barry Hall throw him say he's a natural.
Hey, how you feel? Deep breath, mate. You're all right. Right the body, the jab, and right the body, work a bit, double it. Don't come back up the head with the right hand. Right the body,
double what?
Right the body, come back and right the hand.
Right the head.
Right the body, right the head.
Leave that left hand up. Leave the three up.
Nice and tight on the really good, beautiful round. One of our minds.
Here we go, round number two, a very controlled corner. The corner of Shane Cameron. Very neat and tidy boxer, Shane. He could be a wild one, a father of Scottish descent, a mother of Maori descent. An indifferent mix, but a fiery one nonetheless. Good upper body movement there from Dominic Vea.
Seems Cameron's taking at the body a little bit. It's a few big body punches going down there early, but
how dangerous is it changing levels early in a fight, Dan? Up low.
It can be a bit risky. You know, once you got your distance set, yep, it's not so bad. But when you're not sure of that distance, you know, not sure how long the other guy's big right hand is, or even the big hook,
yep,
you know, it can be risky dropping down.
Hands up very high on Dominic Vea, the biggest test of his career, undeniably. Last fought against Oscar Siale, as we spoke of earlier. That was July last year. There was plenty of time off required after that one. But that was his last fight. I just wonder how long 12 months out of the ring at 30 years of age is going to hurt Dominic Vea as he is near bullied into the neutral corner. Gets out nicely and gets out well, though. Work, Shane. Look at the cruiserweight division in Australia. Danny Green, Brad Pitt, Peter Cronier, Anthony McCracken, Adam Forsyth, Daniel Amman, Mostyn Neiman, Kane Watts, Kerry Foley, Jamie Bogovic, Dominic Vea. There are a heap. What a competitive division. It's very much like your middleweight division on a global scale. Just so many quality athletes. I mean, here in Australia, there's, you know, Solomon, Wood, Mundine, yourself, you go overseas, Sergio Martinez, Felix Sturm, Dimitri Pirog, Andy Lee, Chavez Jr., they are everywhere.
Yeah, you're not wrong, but it's good to see in Australia, like so many guys around the same way that are also, yep, good.
It bodes for some interesting matchups over the course of the next 18 months in the cruiserweight division in Australia and the middleweight division. Of course, that will be highlighted Wednesday, August 31, when the real deal defends, in my opinion, the belt in world boxing, the IBF middleweight title. Geez, he's nice and relaxed, Shane Cameron here. The hands are down. He's trying to loosen up the shoulders.
Playing a few games early on.
You're boxing against a guy, 13 wins, 10 knockouts. I don't know if hands by the side is ideal, because Dominic can bang. Oh, Vea walks into a good right hand. Did not as even buckle his knees.
Seeing the shots, what can we hit him? If we can hit him with the right hand anytime we want, just time that, okay?
Let's take a look at some of the highlights from round number two. Vea walks into a good right hand late in the round, but throwing the more punches was the man they call the Mountain Warrior.
I think it could be smart tactics as well, going to the body early.
Yep.
Might make a bit of a difference a little bit later.
Right for it, boys. Step back, right for it.
Round number three coming your way live around the world on Main Event Boxing tonight. We're going to the US, going to Russia, over to our great friends in New Zealand watching this. A big Aussie hello. Hope you guys are doing well and enjoying your night.
No, no, boys, work out of it.
Dominic Vea, centre ring, the champion, the Commonwealth champion, with a victory over Kiwi Oscar Siale. Took a few shots in that round number two just previous. Going to jump in the trenches, though. Like to see Dominic Vea to your right shoulder, because he'll stay there with you all night long.
Yeah, I think he's got a bit of confidence up. He's holding back a little bit.
Jane Cameron throwing the better punches, and a big performance tonight, and an impressive performance tonight, is key for Shane Cameron. They have designs on Danny Green. They have designs on the IBO Cruiserweight title. And unless Shane Cameron wins and wins impressively, they might well again be forced to wait in the queue. Single shot there from Vea. Made his debut back in November of 05. Fox Sports card, downtown Blacktown, weighing in as a heavyweight at 101 kilos. 90 kilos tonight, some 6 years on. Going to the body. We saw just how effective body shots could be in the opening fight of the night with Michael O'Donnell going down to South African Peter Cronje for a beautiful body shot to the rib. As Vea gets a little bit of confidence, a little bit of momentum. Roughly double the experience of in-ring professional time for Shane Cameron in his 159th professional round here as Dominic Vea opens up from the ropes. Cameron calls him on and it's getting a little warmer here at the Sydney Entertainment Centre as a result. Cameron strikes back. You just have that feeling about this one. In yeah. For a beauty.
Dominic Vea seems to enjoy getting hit. He seems to get his confidence from getting hit.
Some guys are like that. They not only counter punches, but they get confidence from knowing that they've taken the shot and can jump onto their toes.
Long jabs, stay outside. Calculated you're coming in and out. That's all you had to do. Don't rush things.
Cameron going to the body there. Make sure you've done your sit-up work for Dominic Vea. Little short right hand from Vea, trying to create space here and did so nicely. Started short punching Dan and then was able just to widen up a little.
Yeah, it was smart. It was smart because Cameron was leaning in a fair bit too.
You understand that, okay? Don't stand there and try to mix it for him. That's exactly what he wants you to do.
Round number four coming your way. Hope you're enjoying the action. Both guys with a high percentage of their knockouts in the first five rounds. Vea again from his back foot. Starts with that short little right hand. It's almost like putting the small drill bit in the power tool and just popping it out very quickly. Slowly gets bigger and winds up a little more and the impact is greater. He gets out of trouble and does so by punching his way out. Cameron centering in the white trunks, 33 years of age. Lives in Auckland, New Zealand. Left hand still just a little low. There's an opportunity for Dominic Vea with a straight right hand. Cameron misses with that lead jab. Vea can get the feet right. There's an opportunity. Both guys boxing well, Dan, but when it comes back to it, these two guys are genuine fighters. And is it true the longer the fight goes, the more fatigue sets in, the more you sort of go back to your natural instinct despite what you've trained?
Definitely is true. I mean, these guys put plenty of hours of training into this, so I mean they're going to be prepared. They know, both of these guys know that the other one's pretty tough and he's going to be there to the end. Especially Dominic Vea, everybody knows that he's pretty much going to be there to the end, so you got to be fit.
That you do. It's something special seeing elite athletes in these heavier divisions go sparring and go training. It is vicious, it is brutal, it is fast, it is powerful, all of the above. And that's just training. Watching any boxer do his thing in the gym is something quite special.
A lot of the sparring sessions in the gym tend to be just as good,
yeah,
if not better at times than some of the fights.
Now, for the general public to go along and watch a spar, most of the time, gyms like yours at the Grange out there in southwest Sydney, general public are allowed into the gym to train and to see you guys train, and it's a wonderful facility out there. It's yeah, it's not just we're the professionals and we lock the door.
That's right, and I do coach a group of young amateur guys, take them around New South Wales to fight. And we do a lot of other boxing training.
Last couple of seconds of the round as the boys open up a little. I don't think either guy wants to throw too much too early, because they both realise it could be 36 minutes before their night of work is complete.
Okay, deep breaths, mate. And just push on, back it up.
Yep.
Give me water, give me water. Water on the head.
Yep.
Okay, head round. On the head. On his head.
Watch him in close. Well, as soon as he comes to you, move away and use your jab, mate. When you're on the attack, throw your punch. As soon as he attacks back, move. And use your left hand. Get side on and stick that jab in his face.
You have to use your back foot, champ. You see your back foot's stuck there.
Yep.
You know, move the back foot. Look at those long punches he did in the end of the round.
Water on the head, water on the head.
You're going really good.
You're going well, mate.
Chicken.
You're going really good, Mush.
Yeah. All right, mate.
Use your jab.
All right, mate.
This next round is brought to you by Mega 4.